Well, it looks like we got another toasty morning. It is below freezing outdoors.
Just started using this stuff in the morning, and it takes about 20 minutes to make, actually 30 total. But once you make it, each serving has about 5 grams of fiber, and this is the kind of stuff that sticks to your guts. So on mornings when it's like super cold, I will eat a bowl of this, and then I'll have some eggs and toast and some coffee before even considering going outside. Another great tool that I like to use is this Eaton FRX5. This thing is badass. This is a solar-powered NOAA weather radio alert system.
Highs 13 to 18. Lowest wind chill readings 11 below to 21 below zero late in the morning.
Did that dude really just say negative 20 wind chill? Fuck. Go macro. These guys are killing it. These things are delicious. They are low in sugar, high in protein, and something I will be planning to take with me on all my adventures.
You want to go outside, go snowboard? Pro tip. Jump in a hot shower before going outside in the cold, whether you're surfing, snowboarding, any of it. This is going to warm your core up.
Whenever possible, I always recommend putting on your climbing skins before you leave the house. And the main reason behind that is, you know, everything right now is nice and warm. And knowing that it's well below zero outside, if I was to get outside and start trying to do this, odds are, you know, the board would be cold, or the glue on the skins would be cold, or something of that nature. So I always like to do this beforehand, and, you know, on days like this, when it's going to be super cold, you really want to plan your tours accordingly, and it's going to be tough to do multi-tours unless you have some sort of a skin wax, or, you know, even a second set of skins with you.
I want to show everybody the universe testing me every day. This is my dog, Char. And she is just absolutely shaking with excitement. It's not really a good trait, and it's something that I continually am working on, so we're gonna sit here for a while and let her relax before we get in the truck.
So instead of snowboarding, I'm walking my neurotic dog. Still shaking, but this time I think it's more from the cold. Okay. One thing that I didn't show earlier is every day before I leave the house, I always like to put my beacon on, and I actually turn the beacon on. Today I'm testing the Mammut Element Berry Box, and you know what? Every once in a while, you'll meet somebody that gets to the trailhead, and they say, hold on, let me turn on my beacon, or heaven forbid, you're out on top of a run, and they say the same thing. Those are not the type of people you want to be riding with.
It's 12:59 p.m., and I'm finally getting to go snowboard. If you notice, one thing is missing, that is my erotic dog slash best friend slash ski partner, but I think she was shaking this morning. Excitement and partially because of the cold, and so she's gonna hang out here.
Things I like about living in Wyoming and Jackson, Wyoming, the most is within about 10-20 minutes of town, you can really get away from people really quick. So, I'm in an area that I like to mountain bike and hunt, sunscreen. And you might be thinking, why the hell does this guy need sunscreen when temperatures are floating around zero? Well, it's still quite sunny, as you can see. I learned from Chris Anthony, he's another ginger, as you can see, I'm a ginger too, that actually using sunscreen will help on your face, not only protect your skin from the sun, but it also helps as a nice wind block. And so on a day like today, what I like to use is either some like Joshua tree. This stuff has the zinc in it, so this is going to make your face kind of white. Or this Leuka is really rad. This stuff goes on quick, dermatologists approve, blah, blah, blah. And then again, you're going to want to have, you know, some sort of balaclava. I actually have two on. I've got a Patagonia balaclava, and then an Avalon 7, and then a baseball cap. This is that surface one that's growing. And you can see those snow crystals. I mean, that is sugar. So, it's great. It's, you know, I think in Utah, they say it's the lightest snow in the world, Colorado, Champagne, but beautiful now. Whatever snow falls on top of it is going to be sitting on top of that layer, and I mean, you couldn't make a snowball to save your life with that, so definitely a delicate snowpack. We're in the Northern Rockies and pretty much across most of the country right now. I'm not sure if it's going to look as sweet on the camera. Man, it's sure beautiful out here today. Received a lot of snow here over the past couple weeks here in the Rockies in Wyoming. As I was talking about earlier, that snow is super crispy, faceted, as you can see here. So as I was walking up, I started getting these fractures. Let's see if I can get it with my pole here. And look at that. Did you see that? That just went all the way to the ground. I mean, this snow is rotten. Rotten, rotten, rotten. It makes for fun powder riding, but as you can see over here, I mean, if you get close to anything that's supporting it, it's just going to crumble. I realize that everybody's probably not as excited about snow crystals as I am, but what I really wanted to stop and show you was tracks. So I'm actually following, judging by the poop, that looks like moose. Watch the snow collapsing under my feet. Definitely a red flag. You know, I'm gonna go up here and just kind of take a look and poke around, and if I'm not feeling 1000% comfortable, I will not be riding today. I'm going up that mountain, and obviously the fastest way up it is the way a crow would fly, but that's gonna exert a ton of energy, and in this particular case, not really gonna work. So what I like to do is try and follow the contours of the mountain up. This is something that I first learned from my friend Trevor Campbell up in Nelson, British Columbia. He Mighty Bighorn Maps. If you're ever in the Nelson area, check him out. And but essentially, you want to make it as easy as possible. So I'm going to take a few more steps here before I start my kick turn. And now, I'm going to kind of aim that direction, and then I'll do the same thing and just zigzag my way up. This is also something that Stephen Koch, big mountain legend here in Jackson, has been trying to teach me and hammer down my throat. When you're here on the kick turn, take a couple extra steps farther than you need to go. And then, whoa, snow is so rotten. I'll try and do this on camera. Come on. And start working your way up. So a couple good tips that I've learned from a few of the splitboard legends. It's hot. And I've been complaining about how cold it is all day.
Look at this view. Oh my god, it's incredible. I don't know if you can see that, but it looks like there's some sort of like ring around the sun. Whew. Oh, this is so epic. Alright, well, I think I'm about halfway there.
It's about 3 o'clock right now, so 4 o'clock no matter what, I have to turn around and head back because I don't want to spend the night out here. What's really cool about touring is I've
feel like a little kid when I'm out here. Always. It's good for the soul. Looks like a great place to do my changeover. Man, looks like I got beat. Somebody else got first track, some sort of animal. I bet they were stoked just as much as I am. So yeah, here at my happy place. Day three. Shreddy about to drop in. A couple last things. I'm definitely going to mount on some food. And you're going to kick out of this. I brought my Stanley coffee mug up. Track up there. Oh, skin track going up. Snowmobile track out.